Welcome. So today we're going to talk about project management maturity models. And these are ways that we can actually evaluate maybe our project management practices to another firm's project management practices, or even between project to project internally for looking at benchmarking and seeing how are we doing? Are we doing the best practices? How do we know? And what are some standards out there? So we're going to talk briefly about four common models that are out there that are used by some industry standards so that we can compare how do we do our practices versus other practices. Now, the way we compare these is relatively on a scale of 0 to 3. So really 0 meaning that there is no practice whatsoever. Then there's low maturity at 1, medium maturity at 2, and then high maturity at 3. And there's several different categories we can rank on. So these are some categories that you could use. Sometimes these are modified. So you notice we have things on coaching, auditing, and evaluation, our portfolio management, control practices, communication between projects, personal development, stakeholder management, how accurate are we at our scheduling, and do we have structural support to actually manage projects? So this is more of an organizational piece. And this radar chart then is a great way to kind of show how well are we doing. So maybe in this case, our particular company on projects is doing about a 2 in control practices. However, we're doing really good with personal development, scoring a 3, and also scheduling accuracy. However, communicating between projects, we have relatively nothing, so we're scoring a 0. So that's something that we want to improve. Of course, if you look at this, the larger the area, the better you're doing. And it's hard to do all things perfectly. So there's always room for improvement, but this is a good way to kind of measure what your practices are. Again, the levels of 0 through 3 go from 0, meaning you're not doing really anything in that category. Low maturity, you kind of have an ad hoc process. No real common structure, little language or support. Moderate level means you do have some defined practices. You do have some training and organizational support. So a lot of medium-large companies oftentimes will fall somewhere in that range. And it really takes a concerted effort of the entire community to really get a high level of maturity. This is where the institution is always seeking continuous improvement on projects. So let's look at those four models now. I just put the first letters on these, so maybe it might be a little bit easier to remember, CKES. So you can use a mnemonic for that. Different types of management maturity models. There's the Center for Business Practices, Harold Kurtzner's Project Management Maturity Model, ESI International Project Framework, and also SEI's Capability Maturity Model Integration. This comes out of Carnegie Mellon. And if we look at these, they all have pretty much 5 levels of best business practices. So we could make a radar chart instead of 0 to 3. We could make one of those from 1 to 5. And then you could actually implement directly measures of these business practices on different skills. So here their level 1 is you have some initial phase. Without understanding what they're doing, that really doesn't tell you a lot of information intuitively. Just saying initial phase, meaning they're just starting project management. Structure process standards, level 2. Institutionalized project management, level 3. Managed and optimizing. Again, some of those words don't quite tell you exactly what they are. You'll have to read a little bit more on that from Center for Business to find out what those different levels entail. Kurtzner's model, a little bit different. They basically say, first of all, you have a common language that's been adopted, then common processes that have adopted, level 2, singular methodology, benchmarking, and then continuous improvement. So that one seems to flow a little bit better. ESI International's project framework, you start with maybe you just have an ad hoc process. You're just kind of making it up as you go along. Level 2 is where you've got a consistent process for managing projects. Then level 3 is you've really integrated it within your structures. Comprehensive then is another level. And then you're optimizing that comprehensive. So I like this one a little bit better because it seems to be a more natural tier of progression of more levels of sophistication, particularly for complex projects. And then, of course, we have the SEI version. And again, these are all just different models. They're not the only models, but they're the four big ones that are used oftentimes. So there's initial use of project management, managed. Again, that term for me doesn't work real well for me. It's like, what do you really mean by that? Defined is level 3, quantitative management level 4, and optimizing level 5. So what I'd like you to do is take a moment, if you can, with a partner, either in the class or at home. Take you a few minutes, kind of dive into some of these maturity models. And out of these four, think of which one does your team or your group think might be the best management maturity model, and why? Why do you feel that that's the one that might be the one that would work for you? Okay, so that's kind of a nutshell of the maturity models. I'll see you again next in class. Thank you.